Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjaleyammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvanni. I am happy to meet you again in the video lecture on the subject Design of Transmission Systems. This is lecture number 11.2. So we are continuing with the brake design. In the earlier lecture, we discussed the design of single and double block brakes, and in this lecture, we will be discussing the design of band and block brakes, internal expanding shoe brakes. So, the learning outcome to the students at the end of the lecture, the student will be able to explain the working of band brake, band and block brake, and internal expanding shoe brake. And the student will be able to calculate the braking torque of all the three brakes, band and the block brake, and the internal expanding shoe brake. And first we discuss the simple band brake. So look at the configuration. So we have a brake drum which is rotating either in the clockwise direction or anti-clockwise direction. So the drum with both directions are given in two diagrams, and there is a string or band, it is called as band. It is a rectangular cross section band. It is wound around the brake drum, and the two ends of the band, they are attached to your lever. So O is the end fulcrum or the one end, and B is another end of the band attached to the lever, and the end of the lever C, where we apply the force. So now O is the center or fulcrum. So from O, the length of C equal measured as the length of the lever, and B is the distance between O and B. A band brake consists of a flexible band of leather, one or more ropes, or steel lined with the friction material. So it may be a leather material or rope, it may be sometimes rope, or a steel lined with the friction material. So any one of these three will be used as a band which embraces a part of the circumference of the drum. So it is wound around the drum, and we apply the force. In a simple band brake, one end of the band attached to the fixed pin or fulcrum of the lever, while the other end is attached to the lever at a distance B from the fulcrum. When a force P is applied to the lever at C, the lever turns about the fulcrum O and tightens the band on the drum, hence the brake is applied. The friction between the band and the drum provides the braking force. Now we have different terminologies in the simple band brake. T1 is a tension on the tight side of the band, T2 is a tension on the slack side of the band, theta is the angle of lap or embracing angle of the band on the drum, mu is the coefficient of friction between the band and the drum, R is the radius of the drum, T is the thickness of the band, and the effective radius of the drum, which is equal to R plus T by 2. If the thickness of the band is not given, and the R radius of the drum is equal to RE. Now we have the limiting ratio of the tension. So it is given by T1 by T2 equal to U to the power mu theta, where mu is the coefficient of friction and theta is the angle of contact, and the braking force on the drum equal to T1 minus T2. Now the braking torque on the drum, TB equal to T1 minus T2 into R, neglecting the thickness of the band. If you consider the thickness of the band, then it goes to T2 minus T1 into RE, where RE is the effective radius, which is R plus T by 2. So here, now we look at the diagram once again. So the T1 is the tension and T2 is the tension. So here we apply the force. So when the drum is rotating in the clockwise direction, T1 will be the tension on the tight side, T2 will be the tension on the slack side. When it is rotating in the clockwise direction, T2 will be the tension and T1 will be the slack side. When it is rotating in the anticlockwise direction, T2 will be the tension and T1 will be the slack side. So depending on the direction of drum rotation, the tight tension and slack side and the tight side tension will change. And here, now we calculate the braking torque. Now considering the equilibrium of the lever OBC, it may be noted that when the drum rotates in the clockwise direction as shown in the figure A, the end of the band attached to the fulcrum O and the slack side tension is T2, and the end of the band attached to the B will be the tight side tension T1. Then similarly, so here look at the for clockwise, this is the clockwise rotation and T2 will be the slack side. So this is the slack side and T1 will be the tight side. So because it is moving in the upward direction, the drum is rotating in the opposite direction. So T1 will be the tight side and T2 will be the slack side. On the other hand, when the drum rotates in the anti-clockwise direction, so in the second diagram as shown in the figure B, the tension of the band will reverse. That is, the end of the band attached to the fulcrum O will be the tight side. So this is anti-clockwise direction and the P is the force. T1 will be the tight side because it is rotating in the anti-clockwise direction. We are pulling in the opposite direction and this will be tight side and T2 will be the slack side. So attached with the T2 will be the slack side and T1 will be the tight side. Now the taking moment about the fulcrum O, P into L equal to T1 into B for clockwise rotation of the drum, and the P into L equal to T2 into B for anti-clockwise rotation of the drum. Now, so using this we can calculate, using this equation we can calculate the P. P is the force which is required to apply the brake. So T1 is the tension on the tight side and B is the length between OB and L is the length of the lever. And the band and the block brake. So sometimes we use the number of blocks equal to N. And it is differential band. So the band is located. So a point A is here and O is the fulcrum, B is the point here and P is the C is the point where we apply the force. And here the terminology is T1 is the tension on the tight side. So T1 is the tension on the side, T2 is the tension on the slack side. Because we are applying the force here, always the end A is pulling. So T1 is the tension on the tight side, T2 is the tension on the slack side, mu is the coefficient of friction between the block and the drum, and T1 dash is the tension in the band between the first and the second block. So for better clarity, we refer to the second diagram, and this is the block number 1. So this is the tension T1, and the tension on the other side is T1 dash. This is towards the second block. So T1 dash is the tension on the band between the first and the second block. Similarly, we have T2 dash, T3 dash. So tension in the band between the second, third blocks and between third and the fourth block, etc. So we continue with that T2 dash up to Tn dash. So Tn dash is the tension on the last block in the band and the block brake system. Now consider one block. Say for the first block as shown in the figure, then the equilibrium. So you take only one block. This is in equilibrium under the action of the following forces. What are the forces? Tension in the tight side T1. So this is one force acting in the left side. Tension in the slack side T1 dash, or tension on the band between the first and the second block. And the normal reaction Rn vertically upward, and the frictional force mu into Rn which is acting horizontally. Now resolving the forces radially, so about the radial direction, T1 plus T1 dash into sin theta equal to Rn, that is the first equation. So radial direction, which is radial direction vertically upward. So T1 plus T2 dash sin theta equal to Rn. Resolving the forces tangentially, that means horizontal direction. So we have T1 minus T2 dash cos theta equal to mu into Rn. So these are all the two equations. So solving the equation, so dividing the equation 2 by 1. So T1 minus T1 dash into cos theta divided by T1 minus T2 dash sin theta equal to mu into Rn divided by Rn. So Rn is getting cancelled. We have only mu, and the cross multiplying T1 minus T1 dash cos theta equal to mu into T1 plus T1 dash into sin theta. Or taking the cos theta to the right side, so T1 minus T1 dash equal to T1 plus T1 dash mu into tan theta, or rearranging the term T1 into 1 minus mu tan theta equal to T1 dash into 1 plus mu tan theta. So, rearrange the term once again, T1 by T1 dash equal to 1 plus mu tan theta divided by 1 minus mu tan theta. So, T1 is the, for the first block, tension on the tight side, T1 dash is the tension on the slack side. Similarly, we can write the equation for other block. For the second block, T1 dash divided by T2 dash. T1 dash is tension on the tight side, T2 dash is tension on the slack side. Similarly, for the third block, fourth block and the nth block, we can write the equation for all the ratios is equal to 1 plus mu into tan theta divided by 1 minus mu into tan theta. Now, we multiply. So, when we multiply, we want T1 by T2. So, T1 is the tension on the entire system of the brake. And T2 is the tension on the tight side, T1 is the tension on the tight side for the entire system of the brake, and T2 is the tension on the slack side of the entire system of the brake. So, T1 by T2, substituting, will get 1 plus mu tan theta divided by 1 minus mu tan theta to the power n, where n is the number of blocks. And now we can calculate. So, braking torque on the drum of effective radius, TB equal to T1 minus T2 into RE. Or if I only neglect the thickness of the band, so which is equal to T1 minus T2 into R. So, this is the braking torque. So, we have two equations. So, we have T1 by T2, one equation, 1 plus mu tan theta divided by 1 minus mu tan theta to be n. And we have another, we can calculate. So, the T1 and T2 and substitute here, we can calculate the braking torque, multiplying by the radius, with the radius of the brake drum. And next type of brake is internal expanding shoe brake. So, this is the internal expanding shoe brake, which is very much found in the automobile. So, when you apply the cam, when you actuate the cam, so the cam will be rotating and the brake lining. So, we have a S1 and S2. These are all the primary shoe and the secondary shoe. We have S1 and S2 and they are, we have brake lining on the outer surface of the primary shoe and the secondary shoe. When you operate the cam, when you rotate the cam by applying the force, the cam will push the two shoes outward against the spring force. So, which will make contact on the rotating drum. So, which will apply the brake on the drum and the wheel will be stopped. Internal expanding shoe brake. And various forces acting on the internal expanding shoe brake. F1 and F2 are the forces, and Rn is the normal reaction, and the L is the length between the fulcrum and the center of the cam, and we have the rotation, direction of the rotation, anti-clockwise direction or clockwise direction, depending on the direction, and we have angle of contact, theta, of the lining material towards the center, at the center of the brake drum. Where R is the internal radius of the wheel rim, B is the width of the brake lining, P1 is the maximum intensity of normal pressure, Pn is the normal pressure, and F1 is the force exerted by the cam on the leading shoe, and F2 is the force exerted by the cam on the trailing shoe. So, this is leading shoe and this is the trailing shoe. And the braking torque equal to mu P1 into B R square into cos theta 1 minus cos theta 2. And the moment of the normal force Mn equal to 1 plus 1 by 2 in 1 by 2 into B P1 into Br into O O1 into theta 1 theta 2 minus theta 1 plus 1 by 2 sine 2 theta 1 minus sine 2 theta 2. And moment of the frictional force Mf equal to mu P1 Br into R cos theta 1 minus cos theta 2 into plus O O1 divided by 4 into cos 2 theta 2 minus cos 2 theta 1. And these are all the two types of the forces acting on the internal shoe expanding shoe brake. For leading shoe, taking moment about the fulcrum O1, F1 into L equal to Mn minus Mf. For trailing shoe, taking moment about the fulcrum O2, F2 into L equal to Mn plus Mf. So, where Mn and Mf, when if Mn is less than Mf, the brake is self-locking brake. So, the frictional torque should be greater than the normal force, normal torque. So, we stop here. So, using the equations, we can calculate F1 and F2, then we can calculate the force required to actuate the brake. So we stop here. So these are all the books I published in the mechanical engineering subject, and I upload the video lectures of all the subjects in the YouTube channel. You subscribe to the channel, use the videos for your better learning. Thank you for watching. Please post your comments on the comments box. So you can contact me through my mail ID or WhatsApp number for any clarification on the subject. We will meet again in the next video lecture with a few problems on design of brake.